So you're not just going to go to the NFT store and hand over some monies and buy an NFT. You actually do this digitally, which means you need a digital wallet. And we're going to cover up the primary wallet that we use and that other people use coming right up.
Hey, y'all. So, you know, if you don't have enough to learn in this whole NFT journey, let's just throw something else up in there. You need a wallet, a digital wallet to hold your NFTs. Now, there's so many different kinds of wallets that you can have. Our favorite that we use that I think is super newbie friendly is stinking old MetaMask. But what's the real reason what are you doing?
As my MetaMask.
Okay, I'm not going to lie to you. The reason I love MetaMask is because if you go to their website, they actually have cartoon tutorials that walk you through so many of my own questions. And I'm like so ADD that I need the little cartoon fox in his animation.
The fox looks around when you scroll around. I actually like
it's
that
too. It's those small things that do it in for me. But MetaMask, 100%. I mean, it's mainstream. A lot of people use it. It's super easy. The point is you need a wallet. I will say just a little note that different projects that you buy, I know that we've covered some interesting ones so far, like AMC's, NFTs, Macy's, so forth. Sometimes these really unique projects require certain wallets and certain ways to buy their NFTs. So just keep that in mind. But for the most part, if you're going to places like OpenSea, you can drag your NFTs right over to your MetaMask wallet.
Trust her. So
trust me.
Yeah. So real quick, MetaMask has some YouTube videos as well. We just want to give it to you from like a regular user perspective. So it's not, I don't want to say there's just corporate or anything like that. But look, crypto wallet, gateway to blockchain apps. Okay. So we use our wallets. This is literally the only wallet I've ever had. No, I got Coinbase eventually, but this is how we got our VFriends. This is how we get other things. This is where we put our monies. And this is where everything is. All transactions are going to take place through your MetaMask wallet. And I mean, I don't have anything like significant, but like, let's talk about where they have to go first. We'll do desktop with Heather and I'll do some screen share on my phone and we'll go from there.
I did want to mention real quick in investopedia.com, we'll have it linked up down below. They break down blockchain wallets and the transaction fees and a little bit about how they work. So yes, unfortunately, there's going to be a fee with every transaction to bring the NFT. You moving anything up in the crypto space, they're going to charge your ass like every single time. So it says in this article that fees are really determined by the transaction size. And of course, we've covered before, if you haven't heard it yet, gas wars and so forth. I mean, there's so many different transactions when you consider about buying an NFT. But just wanted to ruin everybody's day by mentioning the wallet fees.
There's no fee to watch these videos, by the way, but you know what the fee actually is just sharing it and letting other newbies know so that way we could get the word around. But any transaction is accompanied by gas fees, whether you're buying an NFT, selling an NFT, sometimes if you're airdropping or whatever, but it is consistent. Like the smaller the NFT you're buying, it doesn't take as much energy. The gigawatts, you know, Back to the Future shit, like it doesn't take as much. So it's going to be a smaller gas fee. The bigger it is, it's going to have a more significant gas fee.
Okay.
But Heather's got her stuff here for you. So let's check it out.
All right. So when you go to metamask.io, as you can see right here, you're not really be able to do anything. You cannot set up an account until you actually download the extension. It downloads pretty fast. But once you download the extension, you're going to actually set up an account with them. And I set up one for newbies the other day, and I couldn't believe how fast it went. It was literally within like 5 to 7 minutes. I'm just making that number up. But it was really, really fast of setting up an account. I had to verify my identity. I had to give just some personal information like my blood type and so forth. And they let me in. Now, as you can see, we are filthy, stinking rich. our gains are out of this world, and I just don't want you getting FOMO because we all have to start somewhere. Okay. We all have to start somewhere. Listen, y'all, this is the back end. When you have your account set up, you're obviously going to need, and this is going to be another video, but link up your Coinbase or whatever your exchange is into your wallet. And that way you can take your regular money and transfer it into Ethereum or whatever coin that you want to purchase. But as you can see, this is our Ethereum that we have right here, and they have it translated into what it is, USD. And I will say I'm very glad they have these translations here, because a lot of times I think we disconnect from what Ethereum actually is. So it's a little good reminder right there. But I mean, it's just so elementary. It's so easy. It's scary how easy it is. Buy, send and
click
swap.
On it, click on it. Okay? So you could see. I just want to say this. I've had super hard times with Wire and Transact, and they're limited in terms of what you can actually do. So I don't remember what the limits are, but I think it's like 200 and 500 for one of the others. And then there's the direct deposit Ether. I haven't seen that before, so that's new. But it's just important to know, guys, like sometimes it's better to have another wallet like Coinbase and you could transfer it in. Or there's also MoonPay, which we'll cover in another episode, but it's actually simpler than this, in my opinion. But that's all I wanted to say about that.
Awesome. So we are using the buy button to actually buy Ethereum, right?
Yes, 100%.
Okay. So send to search public addresses and so forth. So let me show you guys this right here. This right here is our wallet address. I just clicked it right there and copied. So if Rich wanted to send me some Ethereum, which he does, I would just copy this wallet address and send it to him, and he would be able to send me. Oops, I can't. Insufficient funds for gas. We're so broke. We don't even have gas money.
Broke ass. Broke asses.
Yeah. But if we had monies, that's exactly how it would work. And so as you can see here, if he wanted to, or I wanted to send Ethereum, I could put in how much ETH, and that would translate to US dollars right there.
Yep.
Swap.
And don't think it's weird, real quick. Don't think it's weird, the public address thing. Like, your wallet's usually public anyway. People could see what you have and all that other stuff. I have plenty of people like, dude, I saw you picked up a whatever. I'm like, why are you creeping on my shit? Because it's a public address. So you could hide some things, but the address is public in case Gary Vee has one of his drops and he's like, hey, I'm giving away a Gary Vee original whatever today. I'm like, here's my address, homie. So it's not weird that your address is public.
Right. Swap. So if I want to decide, you know what, screw Ethereum, I wanted to go to Solana, I could do that here, right? So let's say we had two Ethereum, I could trade in one and select a token and do the equivalent. What's the slippage tolerance? I don't even know what that means.
I don't know, man, but it reminds me of Breaking Bad. Where it reminds me where Jesse was kind of skimming off the top, and you know, and then Walter started to figure it out and he goes, spillage. He goes, there's no spillage, you know.
Anyway,
and
you're getting off track, my friend. But it's super easy. If you want to buy Ethereum, transfer your money over to Ethereum, click here. If you want to send it, click there. If you want to trade coins, you can click there. This is your address right here. And I just wanted to lastly mention that I'll give it over to Rich. Account details, connected sites. And there's somewhere over here. Yes, create an account. So we were playing with this a little bit because when we created this account, we were wondering how could we have maybe two identities with one wallet. We haven't really found a really good workaround with that. Maybe that's a future episode and we can kind of figure it out. But as of right now, what I understood is that I can have this overarching wallet and create multiple quote accounts underneath it where we transfer Ethereum back and forth to each other. The tricky part with that we found was that it's almost like if Rich and I both wanted to have accounts underneath this NFT for newbies, we would need to create either trust each other with each other's personal accounts by connecting them here. And we do, but I feel like this is like a little game right now and it's just going to become a bigger and bigger game. And so this is like an identity thing. So the other alternative to that would be Rich and I would have to have two wallets individually, my own personal wallet that has all my real stuff in it. And then one I would have for NFTs for newbies to create the account here. So it was too much work for us. So we decided not to do it, but that option is there. And connecting a hardware wallet, we've covered it in the podcast. We'll make sure we, you know, cover it here on YouTube as well. But why would you want a hardware wallet, Rich?
Why would you?
Mm-hmm.
Because your secret recovery phrase should never be shared anywhere. And if it's online or on your phone, it's susceptible to getting discovered. And that's why you need one. But I'm going to share my screen real quick.
Yep.
I want to go over something. This is important. So here's MetaMask. All I did to get here was go to account settings. So it has a couple of things here. Use blockies, high tokens without balance, blah, blah, blah. Here's advanced though. This is what I just came across. I never saw this before. State logs. I don't know what the hell that means. Sync with mobile. Yeah. Like I want to sync with my mobile because my mobile is far more intuitive and detailed than this for whatever reason. So that's just the way it is, but it's temporarily disabled, it says. So, okay. The other part of settings that's important is there's advanced contacts. I don't really have contacts. So here is reveal secret recovery phrase. Okay. So if you lost your papers or if it was taped to the back of a macaroni and cheese container that your spouse threw out or something like that, get it back here and write it down as many times as you need to in as many places that only you will check. And that's it.
Go ahead and click that button, Rich. Go ahead.
No. Hell no. My balance is less than yours anyway, or than ours. So that's ridiculous. But that's important. Look, this was a lot, but it's not. This is just to get you set up. We have to do a part two for the mobile version. You know what? Let me just do this real quick. Okay, so here is my account. Obviously, you can see I'm broke, but that's okay. So I see my account balance. I see my public address. I see where I could add funds, and it's going to have my transaction history. That's not different. View on Etherscan. When you say view on Etherscan, it's going to show you all the crazy algorithmic nonsense going on behind the scenes. It's the ledger. It's the inner workings of a blockchain. You could go. The reason you could look at something on Etherscan is suppose you bought an NFT and you want to sell it, and ETH went up and the NFT went up in value. You could see exactly what you purchased it for and how much ETH was at that time. And then in terms of settings, it's all the same. But the biggest thing is when you click on the three red dots in the top left, you could click browser. That's going to bring you to OpenSea if you're connected to OpenSea. And then you could go and browse something, and then you could literally buy because you're already connected, OpenSea and your MetaMask wallet. Transaction history we covered as well. And I guess it is pretty similar. There's a request a feature thing, which I'm sure they get blown up all the time.
I just want to encourage you guys. Listen, we've been, you know, so well versed in this, as you can tell. It was for what, 3 or 4 months now, Rich? We've really been really diving into this space. And as you can see, like, we're still fumbling and learning and figuring things out. When we very first started, it was even worse than this. So I'm telling you this to just really encourage you to just take one step at a time. You know, you need a wallet, go to MetaMask, walk through the steps, play around a little bit. Don't get overwhelmed. Don't play with stuff that you can't afford to lose and so forth. It's a lot scarier than it seems. It will slowly start to make a little bit of sense. And they've tried to make it as simple as possible. So don't be worried about it.
Yep. And I've contacted their support before and they've been completely responsive. So look, if there's anything we didn't answer in this or something you want us to expand on, definitely put it in the comments or send us a DM at NFTs for Newbies. And look, we're just going to be out right now. So until next time, deuces.